Hi guys and welcome to a new video. Today I have Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge with me, and today we are going to take a look at the Android 7.1.1 SlimRom for the Samsung Galaxy S7 and S7 Edge. This ROM is pretty stable. For many people it will be even ready for being a daily driver. So before we start reviewing this ROM, let's talk about the bugs which are present here. First of all, the fingerprint scanner does not work. The battery is draining a bit faster than on touch with ROMs, but it's actually enough for 1 day. So you will get one full day with this ROM, but you won't get more than 1 day. So this is something which you have in mind. Right, Wi-Fi hotspot is also not working, and you can't record videos with the camcorder. So these are the bugs which are present in this ROM, and if we actually don't care about these things, you are ready for to use this ROM as your daily driver. Last thing you need to keep in mind is that you can't wake the screen with the home button. So if locked the screen, you can't wake the screen up with the home button. As you can see, the screen won't turn on. You need to press the power button to turn the screen on. As you can see, the screen turns on now, but you can't turn the screen on with the home button. So this is something which is going to be fixed. So this problem is not only in the S7 Edge and the S7, so this problem is actually on all devices present which run SlimRom. So this is a bug of SlimRom itself, and it's not a bug only in this device here, in this ROM. Yeah, the ROM itself is pretty smooth. There are no lags, no freezes, and no black screens. Talking about the bugs and all of the issues of this ROM, let's talk about the features of this ROM, and let's talk about the things which are present in this ROM but not in other ROMs. So this ROM is called SlimRom, and as you can think, this ROM is quite slim. So it does come, it has very, very, very less apps pre-installed, so you don't get any Google app here. The only apps you get is the clock app, the camera app, the contacts app, the dev tools here, the downloads app, the gallery app, and the sim toolkit together with the settings. So this is pretty much everything you get. Of course you get the phone dialer app also, but actually you don't get more than 10 apps. So this is really, really slim and very debloated. And you can also see that this ROM has a different color in the notification panel. It's a bit brighter. It looks like Android 7.1, so there are differences between 7.0 and 7.1. In Android 7.1, the notification panel is usually a bit darker. So in this case, this one is 7.1, and although this one is 7.1, the notification panel isn't that dark. So it's gray, but it's more brighter than on all other 7.1 ROMs. So you can see it has this old gray look. And right, let's go into the settings here. You can see it looks also quite slim. You get two personalization options. You get the interface and the navigation option here. You can see you can enable the navigation bar here, and you can also change the button styles. You can change the colors of these navigation buttons. You can change the buttons, you can change the position of them, you can add new buttons here. So there are ton of options here. For example, you can add the screen off button here, and you can turn off the screen with this button, which is also really, really nice. You can also change the dimensions of the navigation bar, so you can make it quite big. You can also make it really, really small, and this is also something which is really, really nice to have. So you can also choose if you want to see the menu, I mean the three dots at the corner here. So you can say always show, and you can see you have this three dots at the bottom here in the navigation bar also. So they are really, really There are tons of customizations for the navigation bar in this ROM, and yeah, let's go back now and let's take a look at, in the interface option here. So you can see that you get only two options in the interface category. So you get the recent apps panel and the status bar. Let's take a look at the status bar first. So you can open the system UI tuner directly from here. So you can enable or disable icons in the status bar, which is also quite nice. And you can also change the style of the battery bar here. So you can make it landscape. You can also make it. You can also make it like cyanogen mode or lineage OS circle here. And you can also say that you only want to see a text there, which is also quite nice. So this is something which is really nice to have. So you can also say if you want whether you want the battery percentage shown or not. You can choose whether if you want it inside the icon or next to the icon. So next to the icon and inside the icon. So it's hard to read the number there in the icon. So I would prefer it to have it next to the icon. So this is pretty much it. So these are all the customizations. You can't change the button layouts of the hardware keys, which is also quite annoying. And you can't also change the button backlight of the hardware keys. As you can see, the keys here light up 5 seconds, and you can't turn them on or off, or you can't say how long they have to light up. So this is also something which is really, really annoying. And yeah, but I'm quite sure that the Slim team will add this feature soon to their ROM. So, but this is not basically everything. So you also can change the recent apps panel. So in an interface menu here, you have the recent apps panel, as I showed you earlier. So if you press on there, you can enable the Slim recents or disable it. So you have the, you know, this standard Android Nougat card stack recent apps panel, which also has a nice animation here if you close it. But actually you can also enable the Slim recents, which looks basically like Android KitKat. So you can enable it and you can see that you have this Android KitKat style recent apps panel, which is also quite nice and maybe even easier to handle. You can also say how much apps he's allowed to open. You can say if we want to expand these things here, like that one here, so auto expand. You can show it on the left edge if you want. You can change the size of the panel, and you can also change the colors of this panel here, which is also really, really nice. So right, so this is basically it. You don't get more customization on this ROM. As I said earlier, you can't turn off the button backlights, which is also quite annoying, and you can't also set if you want to open the, if you want to wake up the phone with the home button. So this is basically a feature of the ROM, but actually you can turn off this feature. So you can't open the screen with the home button here, because I mean they haven't integrated the feature into the ROM yet. So we wish that the Slim team will add this feature to their ROM in near future. And right, so this is basically it. This ROM is quite slim, and because of that, this review was also quite slim. And yeah, peace.